Okay, in this video I just want to do a couple examples of working with fractions, and what we're going to do in this case is just do a little division involving fractions. And the main thing you need to remember when dividing fractions is that we turn division into multiplication. So typically the idea is if we have one fraction, say a over b, divided by another fraction, c over d, what we do is we leave the first one alone. The one we're dividing by, we actually flip that over, so the d goes on top, the c goes on the bottom, and that's it. And remember, the good thing about multiplication is when you multiply fractions, you just multiply whatever's on top, so a times d, and then you just multiply whatever's on the bottom, b times c. So remember, if you're adding or subtracting fractions, you have to have common denominators, but multiplication is actually a little bit easier because you just multiply across the top and across the bottom, and if you can reduce or simplify, you do. But other than that, that's it. So, okay, so in the first one, we have 6 divided by 2 over 7. The first thing I always do, if I have a number that's not, you know, it's not written as a fraction, we can always write any number as a fraction by just dividing it by 1. So 6 divided by 1 is the same thing as 6. Okay, so we were dividing by 2 over 7. And now all I'm going to do is just apply my little rule here. I'm going to flip the second fraction and make this 6 over 1 times 7 over 2. And we could do this, we could multiply, we could either cancel first, but maybe we just multiply. 6 times 7 is 42 divided by 2. And 42 divided by 2 is 21. Notice the other thing we could have done is we could have canceled. We could have said, you know, so there's a 6 on top and a 2 on the bottom. Well, 2 goes into 2 one times, and 2 will go into 6 three times. So if we simplify, we would get 3 times 7, which would be 21. And then on the bottom, we would have 1 times 1, so we would get 21 over 1, or 21. So typically, I try to cancel things out before I multiply. I found, in my own experience, I think it makes things a little quicker and a little easier. But as long as you simplify at the end, it doesn't really matter. Okay, so let's do our other example here. We have negative 7/4 divided by 4/7. Same idea. We just leave the first fraction alone, so negative 7 over 4. And then I turn my division into multiplication, and my second fraction, I just flip it over. So now the 7 goes on top, and the 4 goes on the bottom. And again, now I just multiply the numbers on top, so I have negative 7 times positive 7. That'll give me a negative 49. And then 4 times 4 is 16. And in this case, nothing will cancel out or reduce, so this would be our final answer. Okay, so nothing too bad. Again, the main thing with dividing fractions, you have to remember division. To do that, we turn it into multiplication. And again, when multiplying, you just do it across the top, across the bottom. And, you know, if you can, I would say make use of any canceling that's out there.